Welcome to Cryptanalysis. We're extremely sorry viewers. In our last video, we missed out on the experienced swimmer Umesh Yadav, who also had a huge chance of making it to the team for the World Test Championship final. The fourth highest wicket taker for India in the Test Championship, who wasn't in action for the past 3 or 4 months due to an injury, looks in good form. But again, the same question arises. Will he be considered above the likes of the pace trio, consisting Shami, Bumrah and Ishant, or other emerging stars such as Siraj and Natarajan? It was a clear case of oversight. We are sorry for our mistake.
Well, talking about mistakes, today's video is all about the biggest mistakes made by franchises in the recently suspended IPL.
First up, the universe boss, Chris Gayle, undoubtedly one of the best ever T20I batsmen. He was bought by Kings 11 Punjab, now Punjab Kings. And everyone thought his aggressive batting style alongside KL Rahul would be their success mantra. But Punjab Kings went forward with an unorthodox option of getting the universe boss at number 3, which I feel was a huge mistake.
Number 2. Another problem with Punjab Kings this season was their middle order, which had new faces such as Shah Rukh Khan. Should they have had gone for the experienced Kedar Jadhav or retaining Karun Nair, who got only one game last year? Although the top three are one of the best, they still lack that quality in their middle order, which is costing them very badly.
Number 3. With the batting lineup consisting of Virat Kohli, Glenn Maxwell and ABD, RCB's batting department is probably one of the strongest this season. But they still lack that solid number 3, which is a gap in that batting lineup. The franchise did not do anything in the auction to overlook this issue, except buying an unknown face, Rajat Patidar, who is not performing at all. Hence, I feel they should have had gone for a strong number 3 to make this batting lineup even stronger.
Fourth, we saw Delhi Capitals going for several overseas players in this auction, such as Stephen Smith and Sam Billings. They also bought the English all-rounder Tom Curran as an extra all-rounder. This was a big surprise for every DC fan, including me. With Moeen and Chris Morris in the auction, why did DC go for Tom Curran?
Number 5. Krishnappa Gautam for 9.25 crore. CSK bought the spinning all-rounder Krishnappa Gautam for 9.25 crore in the recently suspended IPL's auction. With Moeen Ali and Jadeja in the mix and Mitchell Sander and Imran Tahir on the bench waiting for a spot in the team, a spinning all-rounder was never an issue for the CSK. Hence, this was a big mistake indeed.
Number 6. Chris Lynn, the man who had 5 sixes in an over in the Big Bash League at the Gabba, is one of the best T20 batsmen. But he has been ignored by the Mumbai Indians for almost 2 seasons now. The Mumbai Indians have been playing an extra bowler many times and going in with only 3 overseas. Lynn can open and also bat in the middle order. Number 7. Rajasthan Royals had an amazing bowling lineup, having Chris Morris and Mustafiz on the side, which is just too good. But can they alone win the game for you? No, you surely need an extra supporting bowler. Although the youngster from Saurashtra, Chetan Sakaria, and the cap Jaydev Nadkar were in form, they could have gone for Umesh Yadav.
Number 8. KKR not releasing young pacers such as Nagar Koti or Mavi. With Prasad Krishna in great form, KKR could have opted to release one of them and buy an experienced pacer such as Umesh Yadav. Second, Cummins. Cummins, one of the best test batsmen and a white ball bowler, he is just too crucial for the side. His 4 overs should be used properly, and I feel he should be played more in the power play rather than the middle overs so that he can cause early damage for the team.
Number 9. David Warner, the 3-time orange cap holder and 6-time highest run getter for SRH, just cannot be dropped. However, the team management of SRH proved this wrong. Warner, who is surely the Mr. IPL, if not Virat or Raina, was also the captain of SRH in 2016, where they went on to win the championship. Dropping him from the team in that last game and taking away the captaincy from him was very amusing for each cricket fan.
Number 10. KKR, a team with an explosive middle order consisting Morgan, Russell, Karthik, KKR only played three people this season as their top three, Shubman Gill, Nitish Rana and Rahul Tripathi. The only other opening option was Sunil Narayan. So KKR could have gone for an experienced top order player or a nice middle order player so that Narayan could have opened the innings.
Thanks guys for watching. Do not forget to like and subscribe. Feel free to write your opinions in the comment section. We would love to hear from you and what you feel about the mistakes we pointed out.